Hello everyone and welcome to Industrial Shield's YouTube channel. Today I will be talking about the DIP switches in the model Ardbox analog PLC. There are three zones, as you can see: zone top, zone on the left, and zone on the right, and all of them have DIP switches. I will talk about configuring RS-485 and 232 first. For that, on the top zone, you can open the cover with the help of a screwdriver, a Phillips screwdriver, not very big, this one. The DIP switch, as you can see, it's written RS, DIP switch number 2 and 4. If you turn them on, the RS switch is configured and the other two, 1 and 3, needs to be off. Make sure at any given point in time, only one setting is configured on this DIP switch. On the left side, as you can see, DIP switch number 4 and 6 needs to be turned on. Here, it's written. And DIP switch number 3 and 5 needs to be turned off. But once you do that, the input 0.8 and input 0.9, as well as output 0.8 and output 0.9, are disabled. On the right side, in order to choose between half duplex and full duplex, you change the switch number 1, you turn it on, you choose half duplex, you turn it off, you have full duplex. Make sure all the jumper wires are connected. For that, we have a separate video. I hope you have seen that. If not, go and take a look. Coming back to the left side, to choose between the I2C pins or pin number 2 and 3 of the Arduino or the input 0.0 and output 0.6, the DIP switch number 1 and 2 can be turned on or off. When you turn it on, you have input and output enabled, and when you turn it off, you choose the I2C and pin 2 and 3 of the Arduino. Finally, on the right side, the output 0.0 to 0.6, you can choose between analog and digital outputs. If you turn it on, like it is right now, it's digital output chosen. If you turn it off, you have analog output chosen. And that's it on this video. See you soon. Adios, ciao.